This is the MLB pregame show, and I'm Matt Vasgersian, and as we draw nearer to the first pitch of Game 1 in the series, we'll give you the latest installment of our Topps Player Spotlight. Steve Cook will be in the glow, and not only was he an all-star during the midseason break, but he also shined the brightest out of all the great players in the game as he won the All-Star Game's MVP award.
You know, that's one of those honors, Matt, that's just really cool to get. Like you said, it means that you can dominate against the best of the best in the major leagues. Also, remember this, he's a big reason why his league's representative in the World Series will now have home field advantage this year.
All right, the guys and I will be back to get this one started on the show right after this. From the borough of Queens in Flushing, New York, welcome to beautiful City Field. Labor Day matchup in store for you here between the Miami Marlins and the New York Mets. It's Mets baseball on the show next. And here's how the visiting Miami Marlins will line up in this one. What's the key for them to win this series opener, Steve?
Well, I think they need clutch hits. They need the big hits with guys in scoring position because they're towards the...
Steve Cook will stand in for the first time here. 30 home runs for him on the season so far.
Hey, get on for us here.
Right side, hit hard. And a backhanded reach at first, but he can't flag it down.
And you check this out. This is on the inside part of the plate, but he still is able to take it to the opposite field. I'll tell you, that is bat control at its finest right there.
Into the box, Giancarlo Stanton. He'll get to take his first cuts here.
Hey, stay hot, huh?
Runners off for second. On the ground to the left side.
Get out! Get out!
And he's retired here, one away. With that, a look at the batting order for the Marlins. Who do you have your eye on, EK?
Well, we all know it.
Christian Yelich will dig in now, knowing he'll need to turn it on here down the stretch if he wants a chance at claiming that batting title.
What a tremendous year with the bat he's had. Right now, fourth in the league in average.
Wheeler pauses. Here's the 0-1. Drill down the line. And he tries for the backhand reach at third, but it gets by the glove down the line. They're going to extend their lead as the runner scores from second. It's a 2-0 ball game.
Batting fifth.
Oh, this one really hurts. You don't mind seeing this quite as much with the bases empty, but this one's going to cost them a run.
Steve Cook strides in after getting a base hit and later scoring the first time around.
Steve Cook.
Hey, one pitch right here. One out.
A little tardy there. No balls and a strike. A lot of pitches up in the zone here early on.
And that's not the worst thing in the world at this place, but you've got to pick your spots.
Hey, see you to rip it up there.
That misses wide. One ball and one strike.
Yeah, after that last swing, I would have thought they'd go right back in, but that's actually not a bad location because I doubt he was looking for something out there.
Oh, and there's a drive to deep left center. You can pretty much forget about this one. This is way out of here. So a solo shot here to left center field, number 31 for him on the season, as it's trimmed to a 4-3 game now.
Hey, That pitcher's got to be thinking, how can I throw a pitch like that in this situation? That thing was so right down the middle, it absolutely got hammered, and he knew it as soon as he let go of it.
Settling in now, Steve Cook. He went deep in his first at bat. We'll see what he's got in store for us here.
Well, that was a fastball that he hit then, so we'll see if they go after him with hard stuff again.
Pitch swung on and hit in the air. After it is goes. He hauls it in without any trouble, and there are two away.
Now batting.
Offense, apparently not hard to come by tonight as you get a look at our line score. Danny Muno comes to the plate as we get started here in the bottom of the fifth. Chopped weakly to the left. Cook gonna have to. And reined in, one away.
Now batting.
Steve Cook will stride in again, and before he takes his cuts here, let's flash you back to the third inning. This was just a solo shot, but it definitely helped get this offense going.
Pitch your pitch.
Hey, drive that pitch. Oh, here we go.
On his way to pitch number 75. Into the seats, 0-1. Four runs, nine hits, and one error so far for the Marlins. Pitch swung on and hit in the air toward the line and right. Spoon has a beat on it. He's got it, and there are two down now. Steve Cook steps into the box, and we'll see what he can do here. Two on, two away, two home in the inning so far.
Well, this could be a huge inning or maybe the end of the inning. This is a pivotal at-bat in one of the turning points of this ballgame right here.
And he missed the target away with the fastball. It's 1-0. High and deep to straightaway right. Boom. Going back on it.
Gone!
So it's a three-run shot to straightaway right field. His second of the game. And this lead has been cut to just six now.
Well, and the thing that's tough to figure here, you've got four home runs now as a team. You're still losing. I mean, that seems almost impossible, but that's the situation we have.
And the Mets were given a big boost tonight by the performance of this man, Prince Fielder. He's our Topps player of the game.
Yeah, I think in the end, this really could have been anybody's award. But what the heck, let's go ahead and give it to this guy. He's as deserving as anybody.
So that'll just about do it for Eric Caro, Steve. So we're going to see a pinch hitter here with the bases empty and one gone in the inning. Action.
action in the Mets bullpen now. It's both a lefty and a right-hander that start to throw.
Steve Cook
comes on with one away as he looks at a ball. It's 1-0. I think he took a little exception to that location.
Yeah, and so would I if I was down there. If you want to work inside, that's fine. But once you get up over the letters and closer to my head, now we're talking about a different story.
Runs outside, so it goes to 2-0 now.
This is a guy whose numbers are on the rise, and this is a big reason why. Two close pitches, two good takes, and now he's in a great hitter's count, 2-0.
Hey, one time, right now.
3-0 now.
He's definitely looking fastball there, and you know, he got one, but good recognition not to go up and chase it.
Have a rip at it up there, huh?
Reed's ready. Needs a strike. And, oh, he thought that was ball four, but it's called a strike. 3-1 now.
And that's about where he'll sit with that fastball, 93, 94. And that's plenty hard enough to blow it by guys when you need to.
And he lays off ball four. So now the potential tying run here is aboard late in the game.
And for as hot as this guy's been recently, this is a no-brainer. Take the bat out of his hands any chance.
Runner goes for second. Hit to third. Throw gets him. Two down.
Now batting.
To the hole, left side, and it's through, a base hit. Oh, and he runs right through the stop sign. But no, he'll put on the brakes and head back to third.
And at this point, I don't think you could expect anything less than a two-hit ball game from this guy. I mean, he's been as hot as anybody lately, and he comes through again here.
Come on now, one time, let it fly. Come on now, one pitch right here.
Popped up, Calderon is going to get there. He makes the play, and that'll end the inning. Marlins strand a pair. They still trail it here, 4-3. Carter Capps will get the ball now as he'll take over on the mound to start the home seventh.
Carter.
An entertaining game all in all, so if we have to choose one who stood out among all others, why not go with this man right here? He's our top player of the game.
Yeah, you see a couple of hits for him in the ball game. This one was tight throughout, but in the end, he really helped lead his guys to this victory.
For the victorious New York Mets.
Back here on the MLB pregame show, Matt Vasgersian getting you set for the finale of this three-game set. That'll come your way in mere moments, but first we'll take a look at the Topps player spotlight. Steve Cook is our subject, and not only was he an all-star during the midseason break, but from Flushing, Queens, baseball from the home of the Mets, City Field. Today, the third and final game in this three-game series between the Miami Marlins and the New York Mets. It's Mets baseball next on the show. Steve Cook will stand in, and you see what he's done over the past four games, as hot as they come.
Steve Cook.
Hey, be patient, get yours.
And this pitch is taken on the inner half for strike one. These Mets, EK, as they take the field here today, they've been in a nice little groove of winning three of their last four games.
And it's been a good series for them so far here, too. They've been able to take the first two games, and now they're set up in good shape to make it a clean sweep.
Nothing in two count and the pitch.
And three.
He reaches for one but can't find it as he's down on strikes for the final out. 1-2-3 go the Marlins. Now the Mets will step up for their first shot in a scoreless ball game. Victor Calderon will dig in, and this season certainly hasn't been all that kind to him as he enters play with the average down in the 230s. Scorched to third. And the inning will continue as that's through for a two-out hit.
Yeah, he had a chance to put him away.
Steve Cook stands in looking to put the bat on the ball for a change here with the first two guys going down on strikes to start the inning. Oh, and a hearty cut there to begin the at-bat. It's nothing in one. That pitch count, as you see, already standing at 41.
And you don't need Eric or I to tell you about that. That's way too many this early.
Trying to strike him out for the second time. Chop foul over towards the coaching box. Into the windup. Here comes the 0-2 pitch. Protecting on 0-2, so we'll do it again. The windup and the 0-2 pitch. Here's a swing and a high pop-up. Muno is there for it. And that ends the inning. Miami. Anthony Gose digs into the box in the bottom of inning number three.
And guys, this is the guy you want leading off this inning. He's your leadoff man, so maybe he can get things started, set the table for a little bit of a rally.
Down the third baseline. And it's through for a base hit. They'll have the leadoff man aboard to start the inning.
Oh, my goodness. This guy is real.
Steve Cook will stand in. Struck out and popped out in two trips.
Well, not a great start at the plate. We'll see if he can get something to drive right here.
Now he lifts a high pop-up, drifting into foul territory on the right side. Prince able to make the catch here, and there are two away now. Steve Cook will step in now in a big spot here in a game as close as this one.
And a chance at redemption, too, because he hasn't done much through his first three plate appearances. And he can make up for all of that with a base hit right here.
And ball four now as he'll take first on the intentional walk.
And for as hot as...
Marcos Casilla gets a shot now with two men on and two away here in inning number seven.
And we'll see here if he can come through. It can be discouraging to see opportunities like this late in a ball game go untapped.
Hey, I can't see it. Drive it like you can. Let's go.
Hit the other way out toward right field. Spoon on the move. No trouble with this one, and the inning is over. Marlins get one here on a couple of hits. Seventh inning stretch time here at the ballpark. And Victor Calderon will stand in now with two away, needing to really get something started here.
And their chances of getting back into this ball game are growing dimmer by the batter.
Throw. It's in time.
Oh, love it.
Mets go down 1-2-3. They're on the short end of a 7-4 score. Now the skipper's on his way out toward the home plate area, and I believe that means we're going to have a double switch here. Jesus Vega come on now to start the ninth inning as he looks to keep this deficit right where it is for the bottom of the ninth.
And batting in the ninth spot, number 21.
Steve Cook is at the plate as he watches ball one. Fastball, and that thing's a blur up there, folks. 1-1.
Yeah, there's a good one right there, right over the top. And just fire that thing in there.
swing and a miss on the sinker, and it's one and two.
Oh, and he sure got a good one, doesn't he? That ball goes from about knee-high to ankle-high in a matter of about 5 feet.
Turned on down the line. But this is a foul ball as the count holds steady at one and two. One and two, here it comes. Hot shot on the ground is short. Flores is there. Throw on to first for the out, and that is how the ninth inning gets underway.
Now batting, right here.
And, fellas, as always, a few guys we could have chosen from, but out of everybody, that's the man who stands out in my book. He's our top player of the game.
Yeah, he came through with a couple of hits, but more importantly, that big home run, which really led his guys to this big.
This is the MLB pregame show, and I'm Matt Vasgersian, and as we draw nearer to the first pitch of game... MLB The Show's coverage of Major League Baseball brings us to the great state of Florida and Marlins Park in Miami. Tonight, the opener of a three-game series between the Philadelphia Phillies and the Miami Marlins. It's Marlins Baseball, and it's next on the show. Steve Cook comes to the plate to lead things off here in the bottom half of the first.
Third baseman, Steve Cook.
Line hard.
No, foul ball.
But this is a foul ball.
Nope.
And he lays off for ball one. These Phillies, Eric Karros, as they enter play here tonight. They've been on a real nice run of late, winning five of their last six games.
And it's been a perfect start to the road trip, too. They get the three-game sweep to start it out. Now they come in here full of confidence and looking to keep that streak going.
Gone! So it's a solo home run to lead off the bottom of the first. Number 33 on the year as the Marlins will take a 1-0 lead.
And this is just a fastball right here, but I'm pretty sure it's not where he wanted it. This has got some elevation to it, and that's one of those where you know it's going to be a home run as soon as you let go of it.
Steve Cook will stand in to try to duplicate his first at-bat where he homered to open the inning.
And they still lead by that run he scored.
First pitch on its way. Oh, and a hearty cut there to begin the at-bat. It's nothing in one.
Well, you know, you hear it all the time because it's true. First pitch strikes are so important. It really changes the complexion of the at-bat for not only the pitcher but the hitter as well, especially when you've got a good hitter up there.
On its way, the 0-2 pitch. Swung on in the dirt for the third strike.
Oh.
And he makes the throw to first. Cook is retired, two down now.
Hey, have a good rip up there.
Steve Cook strides into the box now. Launched one over the wall back in the opening frame.
Third baseman. Steve
into the windup and the pitch. And this is taken outside for ball one.
Come on, big guy. Get your pitch and let it rip. Let's go.
Inside corner, a ball and a strike.
And you know what, guys? I have been really impressed so far. Not only has he used his fastball well, but he's also spotted it well. I mean,
I got to count one and two.
Location right on the knees.
Come on now. One time.
Trying to strike him out for the second time. Hit hard down the line.
Oh, that's foul.
But this is a foul ball as the count holds steady at one and two. One and two, here it comes. And they really bunch him up on that one as he swings and misses for the first out. Steve Cook will stand in again as we take you back to earlier in the ballgame. This one swing here has been the entire offense for this point, as this home run accounted for the only run they've tallied so far.
Yeah, you got it. No one better. Let's go, kid.
Donnie couldn't lay off there as he offers it a pitch in the dirt, and the count comes even now at one and one.
Yeah, a big break to that one. That's the old 12-6 curveball.
Oh, that's out.
And basically, that thing just breaks straight down.
Outside, 2-1.
Hey.
2-2.
That thing's coming in there hot. 96 miles an hour.
Tap fouled at home plate. Into the windup, here comes the 2-2 pitch. Saws him off here as this ball is popped into the air. And he'll steer clear of the flying debris. Well, you always hope to get a good outing from your starting pitcher, but this man went above and beyond in this one. He's our top player of the game.
And this is what you want out of
here
your starter.
Gets him seven.
And welcome back to the MLB pregame show as we prepare you for game two of our series with the always important Topps Player Spotlight. Steve Cook is in the glow. And not only was he an all-star during the midseason break, but he also shined the brightest out of all. Afternoon baseball now from beautiful Marlins Park in Miami, Florida. Today, it's the second of this three-game.
Steve Cook
will stand in now. He homered in the ballgame last night.
Well, you know, he's been averaging at least an RBI per game over his last 10, so yesterday's performance shouldn't have come as any big surprise to anybody.
And that's high for a ball, 1-0. Eric, these Phillies, as they begin play here today, come in trying to bounce back from a loss last time out, but they've been in good form lately, 5-2 over their last seven.
And on top of that, they've already spotted their starter an early lead in this one, so they're going to let their guy work with the lead right away.
Bases are empty, one man out. And a good comeback fastball there. It's two balls and a strike.
And you know what? These days, so many guys are throwing in the high 90s. It makes those mid to low 90s guys look easy. But I'll tell you what. If he mixes his pitches well, it can still be plenty fast to have to deal with.
Hit hard towards center. That gets down, and he's got himself a base hit.
It wasn't just that he was getting fastballs there. He was getting hittable fastballs. This catches a ton of the plate, and he turns it around for a solid single.
Giancarlo Stanton will stand in. He comes off an 0-for-4 in last night's ball game.
Well, yesterday he just didn't look like himself, but he's been good lately. He's had 7 RBIs over his last 10 games.
And that'll get down for what should be extra bases.
Right here, easy, easy.
Oh, and he runs right through the stop sign. But no, he'll put on the brakes and head back to third.
Well, anybody who calls this place home will tell you, this is not a home run hitting park, but it will give up its share of doubles. This one moves runners to second and third now as they're looking to cash in.
Christian Yelich. We'll dig in now, knowing he'll need to turn it on here down the stretch if he wants a chance at claiming that batting title.
Well, this is a guy who is in the conversation for that batting title, but he's hitting under 300 over his last 10 games.
Here's the 1-1. High in the air out towards shallow right. Altair has it in his tracks. He hauls it in without any trouble, and there are two away. But I don't think he had designs on even really trying it as he retreats with two away now. Time now for a glance at the Marlins lineup card in this one. Steve, how do they send these fans home happy here today?
Well, they have to keep hitting the ball in the gap.
Hey, get a good one. Get a good piece on it.
Marcelo Zuna will get his first opportunity here. And as you can see, he's got that average up over the 290 mark to begin play. And that's a swinging strike three in the dirt.
He's out.
The first is in time, and the inning is over. Marlins strand a pair. They trail this one 1-0. Steve Cook will dig in. He singled his first time around.
Steve Cook.
And he throws the fastball by him here, 0-1.
And if you want to contain his bat, this is what you have to do. Work ahead in the count against him all game long.
Nobody out, runner on first. Oh, got him to swing out of his shoes on that one. Nothing and two.
He's playing right into that big swing from a pitch before. Just throw something slow here, and you probably have him 3 feet out in front.
Ball that's outside.
And he couldn't get him to chase the 0-2 fastball. It's 1-2.
All right, so he sort of wasted one up right there. Now I think we'll see a breaking ball down in the zone trying to get him to swing and miss.
This is in the air to right. Altair is under it. One away. Steve Cook comes to the plate as we get started here in the bottom of the fifth.
Third baseman, Steve Cook.
Chop fouled over towards the coaching box. Pitch swung on and hit in the air. Nieto is in pursuit, but he's not going to get this one. It's into the gap. And he's in there safely. He's got a double.
Right center field. This is a fastball, and he just slashes this thing the other way into the gap. No real chance for the outfielders to cut that one off, and he's going to wind up on second with a leadoff double.
Now to the plate, Giancarlo Stanton. He drew a walk his first time up. Looking to keep this a one-run game. Line toward the gap in left center. That's in there. Base hit. Around third and being waved on home. The run scores from second. It's now 3-1.
You think he was looking for a fastball there? I think he was. That's about as hard a hit ball as you're going to see. He was right on that one.
Steve Cook steps into the box as the leadoff hitter here in the bottom of the seventh. Steve.
Well, you know, he's been on base twice in this one already, so let's see if he can do it again.
Wait for yours here.
Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Now a swing and a miss. Took something off that one, and it's strike one.
That first pitch change can be a tough one. A guy doesn't have any point of reference to work from, and he just can't help himself up there.
Well, and he's got him in the palm of his hand now. It's 0-2.
Boy, he was so far behind that first pitch that he over-adjusted and was so far ahead of this one.
Into the windup. Here comes the 0-2 pitch. Slider. Good two-strike pitch, but it misses 1-2.
A classic strikeout pitch there on 0-2. It's one he loves going to, but great recognition there at the plate to lay off.
To two balls and two strikes now.
I smell another changeup coming here before too long.
Could even be right here.
Down the third baseline. Backhanded. Throw to first is in time for the first out.
The right fielder, number 27, Giancarlo.
Handful of fine individual performances to choose from in this one, boys. But what do you say we go ahead and let this man take home the hardware? He's our Topps player of the game.
Yeah, he came through with a couple of hits, but more importantly, that big home run, which really led his guys to this victory.
Four runs on 11.
So that just about does it. A couple of hits for him in four trips in yesterday's ball game.
Hey, strike this guy out. Let's go.
Sinking liner toward left, and that's in there. Base hit around third and being waved on home. And he's going to score with ease as the throw will be too late.
This is a good
Sonny Marlins. It's Marlins baseball, and it comes your way next. Justin Saunders will stride in now. A couple of hits for him in four trips in yesterday's ball game.
Hey, strike this guy out. Let's go.
Sinking liner toward left, and that's in there. Base hit around third and being waved on home. And he's going to score with ease as the throw will be too late.
This is a good sign right here. These guys were pretty well shut down the last time they took the field. This time, they get on the board first on this RBI single.
So stepping in, number 11, as he'll look to bring home that tying run from second with a base hit into the outfield.
Like there, come on.
First pitch has him dancing to avoid it. It's ball one. Eric, these Phillies, as they begin play here today, they enter this one off a loss after winning 5 of 7 prior to that.
And on top of that, they've already spotted their starter an early lead in this one, so they're going to let their guy work with the lead right away.
Lined back over second. That's in there. Base hit. And they're not going to get him. He's in there at the plate.
Think he was looking for a fastball there? I think he was. That's about as hard a hit ball as you're going to see him. He was right on that.
Marcell Ozuna steps in looking to get it going offensively. Things have not been going his way of late. Runners are at first and second with one away. Smoked on the ground, left side. And just past his outstretched glove into left, a base hit. The relay. And he gets back in time, safe at second base.
Batting six.
Nick Franklin will stand in for the first time now, hoping to break out of this little 7-game dry spell at the plate. This is hit the other way out toward left field. Burrows on the move. He gets there to make the catch, but this should bring home a run as the runner tags from third. And no chance there. He'll make it to third safely.
Good work there to pick up that second run of the inning. He just gets the ball airborne, and it's plenty deep enough to pick up the RBI.
Edward Curran steps into the box, and we'll see what he can do here. Two on, two away, two home in the inning so far.
Well, this could be a huge inning or maybe the end of the inning. This is a pivotal at-bat.
And we'll have to leave it there as this is strike three, and that will retire the side. Riding into the box, Steve Cook. He came through with an RBI single in his last at-bat. Here's the first pitch to him. And they pitch out here, but nothing's going on.
Hey, get your pitch right now.
Oh, pretty healthy hack that time. It's one and one.
Now, he's probably lucky he didn't make contact on that one.
Now, let it fly. Hey, come on now, big dog. Get your pitch.
And the 1-1 is in the air now out to center. Calling for it, Nieto. And he brings it in for the second out of the inning. Steve Cook will dig in now. A single and a flyout for him in two trips thus far.
You know, I think he's had a good approach in each of his first two at-bats. He seems to be seeing the ball well and putting some decent swings on it.
And that's inside for a ball, 1-0.
That curveball sort of backed up on him a bit. You've got to make sure you don't leave that out over the plate.
Hey, let it fly. Let it fly right here.
Fifth inning, 2-1 our score.
Let her fly, let her fly.
And he won't bite at that one either. It's 2-0.
Yeah, he's looked at two close pitches. You get the feeling that this is the calm before the storm. I think he'll unload on this one if this thing is anywhere near the zone.
Here's the 2-0. Lifted in the air to right field. Altair giving chase. And that ends the inning. Marlins leave one. They lead it 2-1. Digging in to try it again. Steve Cook. He flew out in his last at bat.
Steve Cook.
I need you right here, kid. Drive something.
First offering on its way. Hit out towards second. Jeanette has it. And that will conclude matters here in the seventh. Jack Duarte will step in now in a big spot here in a game as close as this one.
And a chance at redemption, too, because he hasn't done much through his first three plate appearances. But he can make up for all of that with a base hit right here.
Trying to hold the lead. Drilled down the line. And this will get by him at third. Down the line. It's a fair ball. Throw comes in quickly now, so that tying run will be forced to hold on at third here. Still with... And guys, a good outing on the mound for the man you see right there, the recipient of our Topps Player of the Game Award.
Yeah, I thought he turned in a really good performance. His fastball had some good line.